Our next guest is a man of many talents. He's a playwright, screenwriter, producer, and director of major blockbusters.
His list of credits include American Pie, Little Fockers, Ants, and the Academy Award-nominated film about a boy. And now he's here to tell us more about his new movie, Grandma. Mr. Weitz, welcome to Arise 360.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for being here.
You do just about everything in the entertainment business. How many hats do you wear? Which one are you wearing today?
Yeah.
Which one do you like wearing most?
I'm just wearing my favorite wig going bare today, yeah.
Okay, that's good. Just being you. Just Paul today, huh?
Yeah.
I like that. Okay.
Okay, so let's talk about working with Lily Tomlin. Yeah. My goodness, what a coup.
Yeah, for sure. Actually, I got to work with her on a film called Emission, where she played Tina Fey's mother, and I had such a good time working with her and hanging out with her sort of while the cameras weren't rolling. And she's so funny and so edgy that I really wanted to do a movie that was based on her and on the idea that there's this grandmother who is sort of twice as punk rock as her granddaughter who shows up in this movie needing her help.
Now, and you wrote, directed, produced this new film?
Yeah, produced along with my friends Dan Bogleyan and Andrew Maiano. So I feel slightly ashamed of certainly producing-wise, I have a hell of a lot of help, so.
Okay, well, we have a clip. Let's take a look
and
then talk more.
Okay.
You're gonna have to get the money, Cam.
Look, who is this?
It's my grandma.
Half. Give us half the money.
Yo, Grandma, what you doing here?
You know you're gonna have to take responsibility for this, too.
How do I know it was me?
What?
You heard me?
I didn't sleep with anyone else.
Slept with Mike?
Yeah, like a year ago, and we used a condom.
Yeah, why didn't you use a condom? Or for humanity's sake, get a vasectomy?
What? What did she just say?
She didn't say anything, okay?
Look, she said it wasn't her time. Oh, yeah.
Her time? What are you, a moron? What are you, both morons? Don't they teach kids sex ed anymore?
Listen, Grandma, you better watch yourself.
Look at this sorry ass loser. Some people should not grow beards. Your face looks like an armpit.
Now, did you write that line?
I did. Well, you know what?
It actually all seems very tailor-made for her.
it really is. And actually, that line, I was using another part of the anatomy for her to insult Nat. And Lily wanted, she was go for like an armpit joke. While she's incredibly blue and improvised a lot of very interesting swearing in the movie, she doesn't want to make fun of certain parts of the anatomy. So we worked together on that one.
Wow. Now, your main character, Sage, we saw there in the clip, she's actually going on this sort of like road trip with her grandma to raise money for an abortion, which is a very sensitive topic still.
Well, it really is. But, you know, I can remember seeing Fast Times at Ridgemont High, which is this terrific comedy, which brought us, you know, Sean Penn, among other people, as Piccoli. But at the same time, there was a character played by Jennifer Jason Leigh who was going through something similar to what Sage is going through in this movie. And it's a topic that is sort of a third rail in American culture, and it's easy to forget that it's actual human beings having to make these decisions. And in this movie, really what's happening is it's a multi-generational female-dominated movie, but Lily is kind of teaching her granddaughter how to stand up for herself and how to say screw you to people when they need saying, when they need that side of them.
Did you have any trepidation about tackling a topic so complex, especially now? You call it the third rail, and it very much is.
I had a lot of trepidation about it. And at the same time, I felt that it's so many millions of women in America have had to have this decision about whether they're going to go through with a pregnancy or not. It's a fallacy that I think almost anybody in America doesn't know somebody who's had to make this difficult decision. I try to treat it with humanity in it. There's a point early on where Lily says to her, look, you've thought about this, right? Because it's something that you'll think about every day, some moment every day for the rest of your life. And it's dealt with, just the story of these two very different people bonding is dealt with a lot of humor stuff. And I had this great, beautiful cast surrounding them as well, including Laverne Cox as sort of Lily's oldest friend, who's wonderful in Orange is the New Black. Sam Elliott plays a great role, Marsha Gay Harden. So honestly, it was this fantasy of writing these roles and then having happily my first choice for everyone doing it.
Yeah, and is it? Oh, yeah. I was gonna say, is it true that you actually shot this whole film in 19 days?
I did.
Why so fast? And did that that hurt or help your creativity?
There's only one car crash in it. In this case, it helped my creativity because I had a lot of time ahead of time with Lily to work on the script and to work on the humor, and the sort of dramatic aspects of the character. And the thing is, happily, like, your budget doesn't affect whether a movie is funny or emotional or not. So I was able to do it like that. And, you know, I've done a lot of, it was far less than the private jet budget on Little Fockers, for sure. So, you know, I've done different movies, a different scope, and I was just happy that this was the way to do this one.
Well, talk to us about that, because you've obviously worked on big blockbusters. Yeah. What's it like to work on a smaller film for you, and which do you prefer, actually?
I think every story has an appropriate budget level, mm-hmm. and this was so intimate. I feel like a low budget really works for something where you feel like you're in the room with those characters. Yeah. And look, the great thing is, having worked on bigger budget things, I can get someone like Nat Wolff, who's starring in this film Paper Towns coming up. You know, they'll come, or John Cho, who I've worked with over the years, who starred in Harold and Kumar. They'll come do stuff for me because we know each other. And when it comes down to it, actors are just actors. Even if they're making $20 million a film, part of them wants to go back to when they were doing theater or doing stuff that they were doing purely because it meant something to them. Yeah. And also, Lily was a big draw for all the actors.
Definitely. Yeah. And before you go, we have to ask you about the Tribeca Film Festival.
Cool.
You went last night. There's another premiere tonight. How's it being received so far?
Last night, it was really great. Last night was in a gigantic theater with a really high ceiling, and selfishly, like, really high ceilings, sometimes you can't hear the laughter as well, but it played really great. And my brother and my film, About a Boy, was the very first film at the very first Tribeca Film Festival right after 9/11.
Wow.
And it was this incredible experience. Like, Nelson Mandela was at the opening ceremonies.
Wow.
And so I've always had a soft spot in my heart for Tribeca.
All right. Well, good luck there tonight as well.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thanks for having me.
We'll be watching.
Cool.
Yes.
All right. And you're watching Arise Entertainment 360.